Welcome to the Invest in New York Childcare Deserts Grant Application Overview. During this session, we will review the steps you need to take in order to access and complete the grant application. The first step is to access the grant portal by clicking the portal login link and logging in using your personal NY.gov ID. If you do not already have an NY.gov ID, you can create one by clicking on the Create an Account link and registering for a new personal NY.gov account. If you already have a personal NY.gov account, it is not necessary to create a new one. After logging in with your NY.gov ID, click on the Apply/Review button next to Invest in New York, Childcare Deserts, RFA number 1. If you would like to view the application in a language other than English, click on the language drop-down menu on the top left of the page and select the appropriate language. The Childcare Deserts grant application is available in 12 languages. Clicking on the Review/Apply button will bring you to the provider verification screen. To complete the verification steps, you will need to enter the license or registration number that you received after completing the Childcare Deserts orientation. Enter that number here and choose the correct radio button for either New York State provider or New York City provider and click Search. Please note that if your license date is prior to January 28, 2022, or if your base RFA desert score is less than 30, then you will not be able to proceed past this point. If you need help finding your license or registration number, select the link that says, "Where can I find my license/registration number?" After selecting your facility, a security code will be sent to the email associated with that license or registration number in the New York City or New York State database. If you do not receive the security code, be sure to check your spam or junk folder. The code is good for 10 minutes. After locating the security code, return to the application and enter the security code into the field, then click the Next button. After verifying your identity, you will be brought to the application instructions page. There are 8 steps to the application process: general applicant information, program details, program capacity information, options for use of funds, payment information, vendor responsibility, review application, and provider attestations. The instructions section provides information on getting started with your application and completing the application. The 8 steps required to complete the grant application are listed along the left navigation menu. As you progress through the application, steps will turn purple as they are completed. You cannot skip ahead and must complete the steps in order. After reviewing the instructions, click Next to get started completing the application. Step 1 is general applicant information. Most of the fields are pre-populated and cannot be edited. If any of this information is not correct, please contact your licensor or registrar. Be sure to scroll to the bottom of the page and select the operator or director's race, ethnicity, and gender. Confirm that you are authorized to complete this application on behalf of the program and confirm that you have completed the orientation. If you select No here, you must exit and return once you have completed the orientation. Click the Save and Next button to continue. After the application is saved, an application number is created. If needed, you can exit and return at a later point in time to complete the application. Step 2 is program details. The program details step provides you with the estimated total base score for the application. The score is automatically calculated using the points category and Regional Economic Development Council, or REDIC, where the applicant's facility will be located. Estimated RFA base scores can go up to 100 points. The higher the base score, the more likely a program is to be funded, but no program is guaranteed funding. The base score does not include bonus points that are available for infant and toddler care or non-traditional hours. Be sure to scroll to the bottom of the page and complete all the required information. Review the commitment to submitting licensing information within 60 days and check the box next to the "I agree that I will submit" statement if you agree. Read the minimum qualification statement and type your full legal name before clicking the Save and Next button. Step 3 is program capacity information. The program capacity information step allows you to enter information for planned capacity, number of infant toddler slots, and non-traditional hours if applicable. For some, this information will be pre-populated. Ensure it is correct and enter any missing information. If your program will be providing non-traditional hours, enter your hours of operation and click the Save and Next button. Step 4, Options for Use of Funds, ensures providers are aware of the allowable expenses if grant funds are received. Read the information on this page and click on the link to review the list of allowable expenses. Acknowledge that you agree and click the Save and Next button. Step 5 is payment information. All grant payments will be made to awardees through the statewide financial system known as SFS with a unique SFS 10-digit numeric ID for the awardee. How you proceed on this page will depend on if you already have an SFS ID or if you need to create one. If you already have an SFS vendor ID, you can select a yes here and enter your SFS vendor ID number into the application. If you do not have an SFS vendor ID, you will be required to submit a W-9 form, which will begin the process of establishing your facility as an SFS vendor if a grant award is made. After receiving notice of an award, providers will receive an email with their new SFS vendor ID with instructions on how to use your account. As you complete this page, please note that if your registered legal business name is not on record with OCFS or NYC DOHMH, you will see a message to obtain a legal business name and submit the W-9 form prior to any final approval award being issued. Click on the W-9 form and complete the information before clicking the Save and Next or Exit button. Remember, if you need to gather additional information, you can save your application and come back to it later. Step 6 is a questionnaire required to be completed in its entirety to ensure OCFS can make an accurate determination of your integrity as an applicant to the Invest in New York Childcare Emergency Request for Applicants. Answer yes or no to each of the 13 questions. If you select yes to any of the questions, you will be required to enter additional information or upload documentation to continue. Type your responses to each of the follow-up questions into the provided text box. To add documentation through file attachments, click on the Upload button. The attached document will appear in the Uploaded Files area with an option to download or delete the file from that question's response. To review definitions used on this page, select the Click Here to View the Definition of Terms button. Then, read through each of the certification statements and complete the necessary information in the Open and Operating section. When you have completed this step, click the Save and Next button to move to Step 7. Step 7 gives applicants the opportunity to review and edit any information in the application prior to submission. Click on the Edit button above any section if information in these steps requires updating. The last step of the application is reviewing and agreeing to the final attestation terms and conditions, as well as the audit and monitoring requirements. Scroll down the page and read carefully all the items under As an Applicant of the Invest in New York Childcare Grant, I Attest That. After you have carefully read all the items on this step and answered the administrative questions, sign the application by typing your full legal name into the text entry field and click Submit. Once an application is submitted, you can download a PDF of your application. You will receive an email immediately confirming the submission of the application with the subject NYS OCFS Deserts Grant Application Submitted. For more information on the Invest in New York Childcare Deserts Grant and to find additional information on each of the steps in the application process, visit the Childcare Deserts Grant website at ocfs.ny.gov/programs/childcare/deserts.